Developmental implications of visual field loss.
If I see a child who is at risk of having a field loss, and I measure that, and I come up with they do have a left-sided field loss, or a quadrant of their field is missing, what implications does that have for the child and the parent? Well, there are lots of things to think about. One thing is, of course, moving around. I said that peripheral vision is important for moving around. So if a person has a left field loss, they might bump into things on the left, not be able to judge distances and depth very well if they're going in that direction or if they're reaching in that direction. I see children who have cerebral palsy, and so they may have a hemiparesis on that side. They also have a field loss. Their hand is not used very well. Well, that hand is in the non-seeing field. So what I try to do is say, well, what are the implications for daily life for all of the things at the developmental of that child, where they are? Are they walking? Are they reaching? And I try to help, and teachers of the visually impaired are really important in this, and an orientation mobility specialist, to judge, well, how can we help the child and the parent and the teacher place things in the right place for the child, give them an opportunity to have that non-seeing hand over in their seeing field, move things over so they can see things, let them move things if they want to, that kind of thing.
In a series of two photographs, a young boy is sitting with his neck supported while a purple ball inside a bright yellow frame is introduced into his field of vision. In the second photo, the ball is moved to the boy's right visual field and his eyes look toward the ball.
I want to say again, reemphasize that getting a specialist who works with a child, an educator, who works with a child who's called a teacher of the visually impaired, and specifically and importantly an orientation mobility specialist, is very important. Those people will evaluate the child in their functional environment. I'm just measuring the field, and I see some of the things they might do or not do in a clinical setting, but nothing like how they go up and down stairs, how they, you know, hit a ball when they're batting or catch a ball, how they ride a bicycle if they're able to do that, or just simply walk around. That has to be done and helped. The parents have to be helped in understanding the consequences of their field loss by these specialists.
Fade to black.